Hello students, good morning. I hope you all are fit and fine. So let us start our English class today. So today we are going to discuss module 3 in this class. So before starting our today's class, let us do a quick recap of what we did in our last class. So in our last class, we have discussed module 3. And what we have done? We have done word dictation under I listen section. And we have also done the synonyms and meanings under the section vocabulary. So today we are going to discuss section C, that is grammar, singular and plural nouns, and the use of has and have. So let us move forward. So let us quickly discuss the objective of today's topic. First one is to learn the difference between singular and plural nouns. So here in this topic, we are going to learn about the difference between the singular and plural noun. And second, to know about the use of has and have. So we will be learning how to and where to use has and have. So let's proceed. Now, the definition. So what is the definition of singular and plural noun? First, a singular noun names one person, place, thing or idea. So when we say singular noun, it represents only one. And when we say plural, it represents many. Singular means one and plural means many. Here I can say you that this is single finger, one finger, and these are the many fingers. So it represents plural. So in this picture, you can see there is only one player in the singular noun. He is playing football. And in the plural noun, it names more than one person, place, thing or idea. So here you can see the picture of two players. That means it is more than one. So what is the meaning of singular? Singular means one and plural means more than one or many. So I hope the conception is clear to you. Now let us move forward. Now let us understand it in a descriptive way. Now let us read how to use the singular and plural. Read and understand the following sentences. A boy was reading a book. Second, some boys were reading books. So here the nouns boy and book stand for only one person or thing. Then these are called as the singular nouns. That means a boy and book, these are represents only one. A boy, a book, one. On the other hand, the nouns boys and books stand for more than one person, and therefore these are the plural nouns. Now let us come to a few examples given here. You can see a shoe, shoes. Here you have seen one picture of a shoe, and when it, and on the other hand there are two shoes, so it has become shoes, s-h-o-e-s, shoes. The next one is a flower, single flower, and the next, and what is the next one? The next one, that is a plural form of this one, flowers. Here you can see there is a picture of two flowers, so it is two flowers. Now I hope it is clear to you. Now let us move to the next slide. So now there are some of the, let us learn the rules of making plural. Number one, the plurals of nouns are mostly formed by adding s to the singular. So generally when we are making the plurals, we are using s with the a given word. So when we put the s, it becomes singular. So here you can see the first one is given pencil. So the plural form of pencil is pencils. So in this picture you can see there are four pencils, so it has become pencils. The second, book, books. A few more are there: egg, eggs, cat, cats, cow, cows, and table, tables. So these are the making of the plural by adding the simple s. Now there are more rules of making plurals also. Let us see. Now the second point, for nouns ending in s, sh, ch, double s, o or x, plurals are formed by adding es to the singulars. Now while doing the plural forms, what we do, while there is the nouns, for example the verbs that ends in s, sh, ch, ss, o or x plurals, and whenever it's the word ends in these letters, then while doing the plurals we are using es to the singulars. So let us see the examples of this. First, it has been given watch, w-a-t-c-h, watch. So here what we can see in the ending ch, so we have learned here whenever there is ch we have to use es, so it has become watches. The next one is brush, B-R-U-S-H, brush. So it has become brushes, B-R-U-S-H-E-S, brushes. So what we have seen here? Here we have seen S-H. The next one is mango, M-A-N-G-O, mango. Now the plural will be mangoes, M-A-N-G-O-E-S, because the word mango, it ends in with the letter O. Now next come for word fox, F-O-X, fox. So what it the word it ends in X, so it will be F-O-X-E-S, foxes. Next one, here we can see double S. So G-L-A-S-S, glass. So whenever there is double S, we have to also use E-S. So what we can see here, G-L-A-S-S-E-S, glasses. The next one is dish, D-I-S-H, dish. So what it has become, D-I-S-E-S-H-E-S, dishes. So I hope students, the rules of plurals is clear to you. So making the plurals by adding S or by adding ES with the singular words. Now let us move forward to the exercise 3.1 from the book. Now in this exercise 3.1, what we can see? Write the plural form of each noun. So here you can see the first one is done for us. So in this, what is the sum of the examples are given? Some of the words are given along with the pictures. So we have to make the plurals of the given pictures. Let us do, number one is done for us. Let us read it. Dress. D-R-E-S-S, dress. So we can see there is a one dress singular form. So the next one, what we can see, on the other hand, there are two dress. So it will become dresses. D-R-E-S-S-E-S, dresses. The next one is glass, G-L-A-S-S, glass. So dear students, what we have learned, then whenever there is a word ends in double S, there also we have to use E-E-S-S, glasses. So here it will become G-L-A-S-S-E-S, glasses. So the next words like wish, peace, peach, lunch and brush, these words, the plural form of these words, you will do it by yourself. Now let us move forward the next question. Okay, the next question, you will do it as a homework. So now let us move forward to the next topic, the use of has and have. Now what is it? Let us read it. So has is used with the singular nouns and have is used with the plural nouns. So we are using the word has with the singular nouns and have with the plural nouns. So we will learn it with the help of the example. So first example we can see here, we use has with the pronouns he, she and it. For example, when we say he has a clever dog or he has a nice dog, a brown dog. So what the word we have used here? We have used has. But and she has a beautiful dress and it has a lovely color. So we use here has. Now when we where we use have, we use have with the pronouns I, we, you and they. So we will be discussing the examples next. So always remember, the has is used with the singular nouns and have is used with the plural nouns. So we use has with he, she, it and we use have with the pronouns I, we, you and they. Now let us move forward. What is given in the book? Let us see. So in the remember part, it has been given that has and have are the doing words or action words that show belongingness. So has and have, it shows belongingness of anything. Now we use has with the pronouns he, she and it. Already we have discussed. We use have with the pronouns I, we, you and they. And so again, let us revise it. Singular nouns use has and plural nouns use have. So I hope it is clear to you. Now let us move towards exercise 3.3. So what is given here? Fill in the blanks with has or have. So here we have to use the fill in the blank with the help of has and have. The first one is done for us. It has a long neck. It has a long neck. Why has is used here? Because here it has been given the it. The word it, so the pronoun it has been given here. So it is it represents singular noun. The giraffe is singular, so it is used has. Now the second one, elephants dash big ears. Elephants. So elephants represent plural form. So it will be elephants have big ears. Third, a rhinoceros dash a horn on its nose. Now, rhinoceros. So, a rhinoceros, it will be has or have? So, students, question number 3 and 4, you will do it by yourself. So, I hope whatever we have discussed in today's class, the use of the singular and plural nouns and also the use of has and have is clear to you. So, let us do the summary of today's class. So, today's class we have discussed singular and plural nouns. What are singular and plural nouns and how we have to use the singular and plural noun in different words. And secondly, we have discussed the use of has and have. So, where we have to use has, where we have to use have, we have discussed. And lastly, we have discussed few of the exercises from our workbook. So, my dear students, I hope whatever we have discussed in today's class is clear to you. Kindly go through the topics well and try to learn it properly. So, this much for today. Thank you and have a nice day.